Welcome to this tutorial on how to make a slideshow compilation on DVD using a DVD slideshow GUI and GUI for DVD author. And the result of this tutorial will be a DVD very much like this one with two buttons. And if I click the button, it will be playing a slideshow. And if you click the other button, it will be playing another slideshow. So, and yeah, of course you can add more buttons, more slideshows to the compilation, but I will just give you an idea how to work with those tools. So, first of all, I will close this one and open DVD slideshow GUI and make a new slideshow. I will check the project settings, which is PAL 25 frames per second in SD ratio. That is fine for this project. I okay this and I add some pictures. I will go to my folder, summer, select all photos by left clicking and holding down shift, importing the slides, and I will add some music too. I'll select this one, open, and then I will export the slideshow. Exports. And here I will select all. It will select export a video file, an audio file, a text file, a subtitle file, and a text file. So this is the one I want. I will call this summer. And save it. So now it is exporting. I will go to GUI for Muxman. It's called GUI for Muxman because it is using the Muxman authoring engine. But the program is normally known as GUI for DVD author, which is another authoring engine. I'll just make a new slideshow here. And yeah, first of all, the settings are quite important in this program. So I'll open this. Here I set the project to PAL, use title sets and advanced modes and animated menus. These are the settings used when adding new menus. Show menu, burn options. You can either select Nero or IMG burn as burning engine. Go through menus. Here's the size of the video thumbnails. I like this size. Just click it and it changes up there. And we need the standard definition, not the letterbox definition or ratio for the slideshow. Like the rounded frame, fill, might select different color up here. These are the properties for the how the buttons perform or behave when they're either highlighted or activated. I like it a bit darker when you click the button, whereas yeah, it's highlighted. I like more transparency. Here on the button, I like to have the text under the image. And finally here, this is where we set up all the paths to external programs like IMG burn or a soft player for DVD preview. This is a program used for previewing DVDs. I don't know if you noticed, but I'm using VLC. And yeah, HC is good, and the authoring engine is MuxMain, as I said before. I'll just save these settings. So now we are ready to make our DVD menu. I right click here and the menu properties pops up, and here I can select an image for the background. I will do that. Find my folder. There it is. And yes, we want the menu to loop. And here we got these properties for for the buttons when they are imported. Now DVD slideshow GUI has finished exporting the slideshow, and to make another slideshow, you'll just do the same things again. New slideshow, add photos, go to your folder, import, add music, and then export to all to the same folder. And the advantage of exporting to the same folder is that over here you can see this is the folder I'm exporting to, and I already rendered or exported the Windows slideshow. So now we got two slideshows ready to import in our DVD compilation or slideshow compilation. I'll just drag and drop this, and these are the video properties, audio, subtitles. Aren't really any subtitles on our slideshow, so that doesn't matter now. Here we can open the, which one was this? This was Summer. So I will add the chapter points for this file, and here we go. There's our summer slideshow. Do the same thing, winter, drop and drag, open chapter points like that, and then I will add a text, DVD compilation block, I kind of like that. Maybe a bolded one like this. Okay, they're not really adjusted to the image or the size of this image, so I will left click holding down the button, and now it's giving me the options to align within selection, center on menu page. That is what we want, so that's good. And these two, we want these aligned properly. You can see the summer is a bit to the left, so we want to align within selection. This one, okay. Same thing with the other one. Align within selection. That was okay. And then we can preview this menu. I hit the preview button. See up here, this is normal, this is highlighted, and this is activated. That looks pretty good for now. Yeah, that is pretty much it. So now I just hit create DVD and allow it to clean up the old files. Now it's rendering the animated menus which means that these buttons are, as you can see in a moment, they're moving, they're not freeze frame representations. There's a thawing, adding chapter points, and finally it will tell us that everything went all right, so we can close this window. And now we set up the DVD player as VLC, so we can hit show DVD, and here we got our DVD with the two buttons, selectable buttons. Slideshow. Now we added the chapter points. These chapter points you can move back and forth between the chapter points. There's a new chapter point for each photo. And the same thing works with the other slideshow, of course. Yeah, so we're happy about our slideshow compilation here. So now we can hit burn DVD, and when we do that, since we set up the project to use IMG burn, and we set up the path here to IMG burn, it will burn our DVD. I don't want to go through that here, so hopefully now you'll know how to export several slideshows and add them to a menu in GUI for DVD author, and make a nice professional looking DVD. Good luck, and thank you very much.